Bayonetta.
Bayonetta.
Bayonetta. Bayonetta.
Whoa, what's this? It looks like it wasn't an April Fool's gag. It turns out that my copy of 8-Bit Bayonetta has fully evolved into this magnificent 3D game. Okay, I'm going to stop with the joking now. So, in case you saw my last Let's Play, obviously the whole 8-Bit thing was a joke. Well, the joke in the sense that Sega was just trying to do this whole bait-and-switch thing toward the fans, which led to some speculation about there being a Bayonetta game on the PC. Not so much speculation, it was Sega teasing the audience with a countdown, and here we are! I never thought in a million years that we'd actually get Bayonetta on the PC, and I'm very excited for that. Because I do have Bayonetta on the 360, the Xbox One, and the Wii U. But the thing is that my 360, I don't really have that plugged today. Like, I don't really use it as often because it is a bit of an outdated console. And the Xbox One, I do love it. I mean, I'm not going to say like I hate it, but there's some problems with the Xbox One here and there. But for the most part, I am very happy that Bayonetta is backwards compatible on there. But the problem is that the Xbox One version of Bayonetta is simply an emulation of the 360 version, which means that it's burdened with the same slowdowns that you experience on the 360 version. And the Wii U version, well, I gotta say, it's the same thing, really. Like, a lot of people tell me that the Wii U version of Bayonetta is better than the 360. Not really. I've made a lot of comparisons between the both, and the Wii U struggles in some of the more heavier moments of action, like in Route 666, where the background just takes a nosedive like crazy. So I wanted something more, and here we are, Bayonetta on the PC, and I couldn't be more happier. Currently, I am running this game on a GTX 970 with an i7-2700K. I've heard people say that there are some issues that's been going on here and there. I'm hoping that that's not the case. I did run a little test before making this video, and so far it's been working out just fine. I've heard some strange issues that people are having, like such as the cutscenes having like this weird picture-in-picture moment, and there's also this problem where playing the game after the first chapter starts to, there's like this weird slowdown that's induced everywhere, and that's the result of the game taxing out during the introduction, which is really weird, but hopefully that's not the case. So, I think it's time I do a brand new Let's Play. Let's do it, right? I am very familiar with the Bayonetta franchise. I mean, I'm not an expert on a lot of things here and there, but I'm pretty damn good at the game. I was able to beat it on Infinite Climax back on a 360. So I think with a little bit of knowledge, this Let's Play should be tons of fun, right? Well, let's play the first chapter, and we'll take it from there. This is Bayonetta. Let's go. We're gonna play a brand new game, and take it from there. In a universe of light and dark, where perception is reality. This is looking glorious already. This is the best way to introduce a game to anybody. Just flat out starting off with the action.
Long since erased from the records of time, there once existed two European clans who served as overseers of history for the powers that be. The Umbral Witches, dwellers of the darkness, and the Lumen Sages, controllers of the light. The clans paid each other great respect, and their efforts to maintain the balance between them defended the just passage of time. Yet one day, that balance was toppled.
That balance is crazy. Hanging on the edge of tomorrow.
The once harmonious clans fell into disagreement and stoked the flames of hatred against each other, resulting in an era of strife. The conflict between the Umbra and the Lumen threw all of Europe into a chaotic loop of battle, ambush, assassination, and casualty. It was truly a gruesome war. Despite the tremendous radiance of God shining upon them, the Lumen Sages were gradually weakened by the assault of the secretive Dark Witches. Years after the battles were lost, the war had ended in the Umbra Witches' favor.
Gotta say, this has gotta be the world's tallest cliff. How long until we reach the floor? That's my question. To this day, it still falls, even in Super Smash Bros.
Their victory was short-lived. Fearing the witch's dark abilities, humans began to condemn the remaining Umbra. They launched the witch hunts, rounding up the battle-weary witches with little resistance and subjugating those who wished to continue the struggle. Human faith in the miracles of their god pushed the witch hunts further, and soon the Umbra witches, keepers of the darkness, were extinguished from the earth. All but one.
Cutscenes remain at 30 frames per second. I'm not too fond of that idea, but it's not a big deal, really. Umbran Tears of Blood. Oh yeah, that's right. Those are this game's variation on the achievements. On the Wii U, they call them Bewitchments, which is the greatest name I think anybody could have ever called it. It's very clever. I applaud you, Sega and Platinum Games. That's adorable. Present day, in the city of Vigrid. Even though I played this game backwards and forwards on three systems so far, I still can't make heads or tails of the story. I mean, I know some of it. I know most of it. I've made a bit of study over it, but it's like, it can still be very confusing. So with this Let's Play, I'm going to try my best to pay attention here and see if I can sort of grasp a little more of the little minor things that go on here and there. I know for a fact that that's John that's assassinating these people. For what purpose? I actually don't know. And now we're off to the prologue, the vestibule. But first, I gotta save. And here we go, we're off. The first 5 minutes, down the belt, or down the drain, or whatever the hell you want to say. It's in the bank. There we go, that's better. It's so weird, because when I look at my Xbox One, it says 99 hours, 99 minutes, 99 seconds. It's insane. It can't go any higher than that for some reason, though. But let's go. Man, this just looks clean. This is so clean. I never imagined that a game like this would look so beautiful. I mean, granted, there's still some things here and there that look a little outdated, like the textures are not exactly the most astounding thing ever. But the art direction of this game is what matters more. The aesthetic of this game is very pleasing. It's got a very red motif to it. which works very well with the sequel, since the sequel has a more blue motif, so it has like this red oni, blue oni thing going for it. I really love it. Hideki Kamiya! Who is not egotistical at all, otherwise his name wouldn't be peed on. Like, seriously, this is not the way to introduce something.
Even Oleg Man the Destroyer gets scrambled in the end, right? You know, I still don't get why the hell you dragged me out here for these things. I just drop off the merchandise. Hey, bet you can't guess what today is. Reading the good Lord's book ain't gonna do much.
I love this guy so much. It's pretty much the spitting image of the mafia or the Italian guys. Forget about it! I wish I could do a better accent, but I can't do that. Forget about it! Forget about it! Okay, I'm gonna stop.
They take care of us. And I prefer my shoes made out of rubber, not concrete. But hey, it's that kind of town. Without good-hearted souls like us to put these bastards 6 feet under, where'd society be? Of course, the pay's not bad either. Jesus, you really get into this shit, don't you? If it were me, I'd be praying he ends up barbecue. Or at least sunny side up.
Cracking a lot of egg jokes there, aren't you?
You can keep praying. But the only way this guy's meeting the Lord is if God's hungry for breakfast.
Hey man, you cook those eggs right, anybody would go crazy for them, even God.
Speaking of hungry, we done here? My kids are baking me a birthday cake tonight. Cute little fuckers, I tell you what.
That's right, this guy has kids. How the hell does a guy like this have wife and kids? I imagine he has like a deadbeat mother. The kind who like, not mother, wife. The kind that like you open the door and she's already at the doorstep with like that really horrible morning gown and that rolling batter thing. You know, like with the curled up hair, ironing curls, I think they're called. I'm sure he has a happy family though.
You can see them, can't you?
I see them. They are instruments of God. Descending upon his heavenly rays to earth.
Oh my God!
Dear Lord, grant us guidance and keep safe the souls of our loved ones for all eternity.
And here she goes into Purgatorio. I'm telling you, I love that guy. His reactions are the best. Third sphere. Affinity. Angels. What do we do with these majestic creatures? Beat the ever-loving fuck out of them, of course! Damn it! If only I didn't pee on Hideki Kamiya's name, none of this would have ever happened! Why do you strike upon me, oh director wonderful you? I present to you my most favorite character in this game, Rodan. This guy is a badass motherfucker. And I don't use that term very often, okay? Because I'm Hispanic. I don't like talking all gangsta and shit.
Move out the way.
the end zone. How about you get out of here?
Look at this guy. Putting out the flames on his own finger.
In that hole, chasing after the money.
Do you naughty little angels deserve a good spanking?
Beautiful.
Uh-oh, things are getting a little sexual. Hide your kids, man.
Bayonetta.
This is all just crazy nonsense. I'm not gonna dwell too deep in the whole nonsense with the SJWs and the feminists and how they view this game, but this is all done, you know, for laughs. It's all tongue-in-cheek. Yes, Bayonetta is sexy as all hell. Yes, she's absolutely gorgeous. She's probably the kind of image that a lot of, you know, a lot of players might wank to, but at the end of the day, it's all done in good fun. Have fun, play this game. Stop complaining. Some people will say that you have to, like, in order to enjoy this game, you have to be a pervert. Not really. People who say that kind of stuff really don't understand the importance of responsive controls and action-oriented combat. This is the kind of stuff I kill for. It's not just Bayonetta. I love all the things that Platinum Games done. From Wonderful 101 to Metal Gear Rising. This is just one of those games that just does it so much better than all of those. It's second only to the Devil May Cry series. He's your lollipop. Look at this. How can you not like this? This is hilarious. A little God Hand reference never hurts anybody. Words to live by. Ah, here we go now. Let's see how the controls are. Oh, that's right. There was a tutorial here. I forget that, you know, this game does have a very slow start. I played this game so much that, you know, well, I think I'm going to end up doing some things that I can't do just yet simply because I don't have those abilities unlocked. But yeah, this is pretty basic as far as things go. Y is your punch, B is your kicks. Use them in sequences, and you can create some really cool combos. Let me just get a feel for this. I can't even dodge offset in this menu. Weird. I guess because dodging comes next. Ah, yes, it is. Yes, it does. Basic stuff, but this game lives on the whole dodge mechanic. There we go. Yeah, dodge offsetting is one of the most important things that one should learn about this game. You can get through the game just fine without dodge offsetting, but it's going to be much difficult. With dodge offsetting, it allows you to continue your combos without ever dropping them while also repositioning yourself wherever you want around the enemies. Normally, if you were to do like a punch, kick, punch, like that, it ends with this attack. But if, like, for example, you dodge and you try to continue it, your combo starts. By holding down the buttons in the middle of your dodge, your combo remains... Basically, you're pausing your combos in order to continue up on it, rather than always restarting the combos. Alright, I think I've done enough here. Oh, wait. Oh yeah, witch time. That's always important. Ah! There we go. Oh man, I can't even hold the button down for the bullets. I guess it's because she's using regular pistols and not the Scarborough Fair that we'll get later on in the game. Alright, let's go! Halos. Totally not a ring from Sonic, but okay. Oh, that's right, I don't have the afterburner kick. Ah, this is gonna suck for a little bit. She also doesn't have her wicked weaves. Ah man, I feel so severely limited right now. Ah, messed up my dodge there. That's better. Man, without the Wicked Weeze, I really can't be throwing these enemies around. I can launch them. That's about it. Ah, here come those little cherubs. Oh, camera's a little weird. Okay, now I can hold the button down for bullet shooting. This is very important because this allows you to extend your combos. And here's the bullet climax. Just rotate your stick and blast. Beautiful. This is much better for taking careful aim on your enemies. Okay, why am I wasting time here? Okay, before anything, options, camera, let's see, normal camera. Invert. Why? Was it like this? I think it should be like that, right? Let me see. No. No. Damn it. Then it should be like this, then. There we go. That's exactly how I had it set on a 360. Much, much better. There we go. Oh, I can't dodge in the air either. That's right. That's another move that you have to unlock. Wow. There's a lot of things that I forgot you had to unlock. Guess I'm gonna have to start pure platinuming everything if I intend to get a lot of money so that I can get these moves. But no time to complain, we gotta follow Enzo.
Damn it, who did that? I just bought the damn thing.
Haven't you figured it out yet? There's no quarter for you in this world.
No quarter. Is that a common term that British women say? Because I remember the Queen from Gears of War said that. No quarter! I'll never understand British talk. I can't be in the air if I can't do these dodges in the air. Gotta be really careful. There we go. A gold? Man, this game sucks.
Radon should be paying me for even touching these toys.
You have any idea how much this is gonna cost to fix? How the fuck do I always get wrapped up in this shit?
Ed and Edna. I assume those are his kids' names because he never actually say their name. He never actually says their name. I don't know if I said that correctly. Anyway, you get what I'm saying.
See? This is why I told you I was going home. I just got held up in the air by some invisible things, and you want an intelligence briefing? It never stops with you!
You keep belly aching like that, and you're liable to wake Eggman from the dead. And I don't think either of you would like that.
You wouldn't want that, because he's going to bring out the Death Egg. And only a hedgehog can stop him.
On our special project before this shit hits the fan.
Wait, Rodan. What about Eggman?
Such a popular chap. I bet they hate him down there as much as you did when he was up here.
I don't know, man. I think with that mustache that he carries, people love him for that.
They kick him out.
Nothing a flower bed can't fix. Fill her up.
You heard the man. Finish up in 5 minutes or you're walking home to your cake and candles.
What? Don't you
God, I love her British accent. If you listen carefully, you can hear the song Magical Sound Shower playing from the radio. That's a little song from a little game called Outrun. I thought that was actually a little cute addition. Forget about it! Nope, I still don't sound Italian enough.
You're still getting screwed in all this too. Of all the low-life scum in too deep in this town, I've never seen one get wrapped up in a fight with God's messengers. Dressed like a nun, too. When you end up in the afterlife, that's not going to be pretty.
I can't help it if I like the little outfits. The toys are nice, too.
His face.
Of a lake. All you can remember is that you're a witch. But now, you're stuck because you gotta sacrifice our halo-wearing friends every day or they'll drag your ass back down to hell. I know, I thought I got screwed, but being forced to slap around the divine for a living? That's really getting screwed.
If I needed a biographer, you wouldn't be my first choice. I see to the funeral. You get me the information I asked for.
Even if you don't need a biographer, we kind of need that so we could get a little backstory out of you. I mean, at this point, Enzo serves as exposition, I suppose, and that's kind of useful, I guess.
The info I got is good. It's going to get you close to finding the other stone in the pair and figuring out some of that lost past of yours. I swear.
Vietnam flashbacks.
After jewels instead of cash, just like a girl. Jesus, can't you take a joke?
Enzo, someone's given you a present. Too bad. I can't stand bugs.
Especially roaches. She says that later on. totally not somebody following you. God, it's just not his day, isn't it? Look at that. That's nuts! All those slow motion sound effects. I love it. I have to wonder if The Matrix was a huge inspiration behind this. Mm-hmm. Or an influence, I mean.
What's the matter, Bayonetta? All that sleeping made you soft.
Let's dance. Okay, something is missing here. I just noticed. Hold on a sec. I feel like there's way more stuff here that's like missing as a result. Hold on. There we go. I thought it was just because the tutorial was missing it because I played it for the first time. But that's not the case. For some reason, all these things were disabled. Like when I started this game, the dialogue sound, I mean, like, the audio setting was set to zero. That's weird. I have no idea what's going on. Witch! Now, for this, I gotta get 3 torture attacks. In order to do that, you gotta build up your orbs. Once you got enough orbs, you could pull one off by simply pressing Y and B at the same time. Simple enough. Oh, there we go. There we go. Beautiful. Oh, finally. Not a pure platinum, but close enough. It's not like Bayonetta to be using regular pistols. That just weirds the fuck out of me. I'm so used to her using a Scarborough Fair. Meanwhile, John's already packing heat with her all-for-one pistol. Gotta go. Isn't it time you had some platinum coffee? Because I can sure go for one. She looks like me, except red. I'm telling you. Oh man, I wish Enzo shows up in later cutscenes. He doesn't get much spotlight, only in the introduction, and a little bit of the end. Speaking of ends, I sure am getting a good view here. Put the ears of the hotheads down home.
You don't say.
It's getting harder and harder to tell the worlds apart.
See, part of the reason I love Rodan is that he's just such a badass character. I mean, he is a demon who runs a bar In hell, how can you not like this guy?
Paradiso, who can tell the difference?
Even harder with Purgatorio in the middle. Fight long enough in there and you'll really lose sight. Why the sudden interest in metaphysics?
It's a balance, right? Even if some of them like messing around with the humans, we've all got a stake in the status quo. But people keep fucking around like this, the Book of Revelations is gonna look like Mother Goose. Heaven and hell are gonna go straight for each other's throats.
Heaven and hell can tear each other to pieces for all I care. I've got my own problems to worry about.
Something's up. Everything was a bit too bracing. And Enzo's tip makes the timing too perfect.
I'm just loving this graphics. These graphics. So gorgeous. The game still holds up rather nicely. And definitely the native 1080p resolution helps it out a lot.
I got a little present for you.
Ah, here we go! The Scarborough Fairs.
Built from an alloy the devil himself would kill to get his hands on. Don't break these, because they're one of a kind.
Oh, yeah. Daddy-like. Or mommy-likes, I guess. Look at that. And you don't just equip these guns, you gotta do it with style. Did I mention this is very tongue-in-cheek? Cause it is. This is silly as all hell.
Calling me out.
Jeez, look at the size of that gun. It's actually a lot bigger than I imagined. Like, I'm usually so, like, in the middle of gameplay, I don't really pay attention to the weapons, but here in the cutscenes, goddamn, they actually are really huge. Look at that. That's ridiculously silly. In terms of its size, I mean, like, it's ridiculously large.
Pounding them down tonight, baby. Not to butt into your affairs, but I'm pretty sure you got somewhere better to be. The guys you're up against aren't the type to wait for you to finish a round.
Damn it, I was about to ask her out.
Enzo, her drinks are going on your tab, buddy.
Man, don't do that to him. He hasn't done shit.
You did beat, motherfucker.
Oh, alright. So that is the end of the prologue. I think I'm going to cut up these videos based on chapters. I might be able to do two chapters at once because I know there are certain chapters that are dedicated to bosses. So, alright. So, tune in next time. We'll be going towards the next chapter here on the PC version of Bayonetta. See you next time.